In the beginning, there was film, then what was known as the cutting table. There were many attempts to find a better way, but the editing of film remained a mechanical procedure. In the mid-50s, a group of researchers finally discovered how to faithfully reproduce a picture on a piece of magnetic tape, or what came to be known to everyone as videotape. However, for a time, this only compounded the problems of editing. The first attempt to edit videotape reverted to the cutting table, where the optical splicer was used by a highly skilled technician while looking into a microscope. Actually, making the edit with a razor blade. Unfortunately, you never knew for sure if the edit was where you wanted it to be or if the splice would make it through the videotape machine when you played it back. Next came the electronic splice, and although it was no longer necessary to physically cut the tape, it still required manual operation by skilled technicians. It was quite awkward and required either two people or one person with very long arms. The first real attempt at creative control of editing was made in the 60s, when Central Dynamics introduced the world's first computerized editing system. And although the system utilized hardwired computer technology, it was the first system to allow the producer and director to make creative decisions without having to rely on machines and people with non-creative skills. Many attempts were made to copy the original Central Dynamics system using techniques pioneered by Central Dynamics back in the 60s. The requirement for a comprehensive editing system remained until Central Dynamics introduced today's standard, the CDL computer editing system. I am standing in one of the most modern, sophisticated post-production centers in the world. It's one of the editing suites of Northwest Teleproductions in Minneapolis, Minnesota. When you enter this room, you rather get the impression that you've stepped into a science fiction setting. Well, it started with science, but it's not fiction. And what is so remarkable is that an extraordinarily sophisticated system has been refined into a surprisingly simple and economical method of editing. As you can tell, it is very quiet. All of the videotape machines are behind glass and are remote controlled by a CDL computer editing system. But it's important to note that this system is not merely a method of controlling machines, but a comprehensive system which precisely controls the very sophisticated Central Dynamics video switching and effects systems, all under full, and that is important, full computer control. And then shows exactly what has happened, what is now happening, and what is about to happen right here on this screen. The editing information on this screen is at all times under the complete control of the editor, who sits here, where I am now seated. Now, before we take a closer look at this remarkable system, I want to make an important point. This system, known to the industry as the CDL, was developed through the cooperation of major production companies like this one throughout the world. As a result, the CDL computer editing system provides all of the basic requirements for both online and offline editing as a standard feature without loss of flexibility. It has capabilities far and above any other system in use today. The heart of Northwest's post-production center is the CDL-PEC-102A. This computer editing system is used to control all of the various editing functions. That is to say, on command, it handles for us both the sound and picture with single frame accuracy. This precision is assured because every videotape frame is assigned an identifying number called time code. And this standard coding is used in locating each frame on the tape you're editing. It can be simply thought of as electronic edge numbers. For example, the editing system locates these numbers and activates the Central Dynamics production switcher. It's a triple mix effect switcher, and it's under full control of the computer. Nearly 2,000 miles from where it will be edited, the scenes for this commercial are being shot on location with a single high-quality television camera and tape recorder, which are completely battery-operated. Subsequently, this master footage with time code is loaded directly on the online tape machines for real-time editorial. Offline machines may also be used for offline assembly. Or scene selection. All scenes are automatically stored in the unique CDL 600 event edit file disk, which means that more than 2,000 edit decisions, such as cuts, dissolves, and offset audio, can be instantaneously recalled. Any of the scenes or events can be trimmed, replaced, multiplied, or reprogrammed instantly with a single function push-button command on the editor's console. No more multi-purpose shift key controls. Let's take a 250 event editing sequence and say we want to do something with scene 104. This editing system displays all of the appropriate information to the editor. In fact, the unique Mimic has 12 interactive displays, which we've highlighted for demonstration purposes. The scene number, the type of edit, video, audio, or a combination of both. The time code of the tape on the record machine, so we know where we are in hours, minutes, seconds, and frames. The time code, or position, of our playback one machine, and the position of the playback two. The time remaining in our production, in effect, an electronic stopwatch. And the type of event, which in this case we'll say is an AB with a 90 frame soft edge horizontal wipe. It's exciting. Exactly what we need to know. No more calculating, no more guessing. To demonstrate, let's watch both the sequence being edited and the initiation of the editorial decisions, all in real time. First, the playback one scene is edited into the record tape. Notice we're approaching the wipe transition to playback two. The wipe, and through to the end of the playback two scene. Now, let's assume the sequence we just viewed was not quite to our liking. Perhaps we might prefer a dissolve instead of a wipe. We enter changes by utilizing simple one-function push buttons, such as start, stop, and record. And in this case, to change the transition to a dissolve, we simply select dissolve. And we can all satisfy our creative requirements and decide if we like the dissolve better than the wipe. Playback one, followed by our dissolve to the end of the scene on playback two. I rather prefer the dissolve myself, but I'd like to add 1 second to the end of the scene. Now I'll simply select record and the whole sequence will be recorded exactly as you saw it rehearsed, plus 1 second. The program you're watching now was edited here on this very system, and the following scenes demonstrate the versatility of the CDL.
The value of life. The lion hunt is a ritual for these brave young men of Eastern Africa. They have an age-grade society leading to adulthood, and the killing of a lion is a very important step in becoming an adult. Strength, durability, performance.
At one-third off.
Steel, for exceptional puncture resistance.
At one-third off.
Steel, the guts of Ward's Grappler 2. Montgomery Ward's Grappler 2 throws two steel belts between you and danger. And it's on sale now at one-third off the regular price. Big, deep tread and savings to match. Ward's Grappler 2 White Wall. No matter how you look at it, it's a steel.
At one-third off.
And here is the tire commercial you've just seen. It's a permanent record of every editing decision that went into making it. If I in any way wanted to change the commercial, I could feed this information back into the system along with my revision. Through the years, editing has always been a little like having a tiger by the tail. Surely exciting, but a bit too irascible for comfort. Today, CDL editing provides complete control over a very exciting creative tool. Now, of course, there isn't really a tiger here, but then by now, you knew that anyway.